So let's talk about gradients in Sketchbook. The gradients help when you want to blend colors very nicely. You can make a lot of cool effects with them, and Sketchbook has a very cool system set up to handle gradients. The first thing, click this paint bucket up here to bring up the gradient options. We have our solid fill. We have our linear gradient fill, so it's kind of just a straight line. And we have our radial gradient fill. It radiates out from a point in the center. How the gradient tools actually work, you can grab the endpoints and drag them around to change the direction. If I want to change the color, I double click and just choose what color I want, and it changes right away. These points in the middle, I can slide them around like this if I want to manipulate how much is being affected. And if I want to get rid of them, I just press this X button and it erases that point. If I want to add a point back in, I just click anywhere along the line and a point pops up, and then I can change the color just like before. And the same principles work for our radial gradients as well. So I can drag the direction, change the color, add points, remove points. But if you notice down here, there's this white area between my fill and my line, and that has to do with this tolerance slider up here. Right now, mine's at 1, the lowest setting, but if I were to change it, so slide it up maybe 140 or 174, if I zoom in now, that white space is much smaller. Now you have to be careful, because watch what happens if I bump it all the way up to 255. It ignores the line completely. So if your fill isn't filling like you want it to, play around with this tolerance slider. Okay, so for the next feature, this sample one, sample all layers, we have the red circle on the top layer and the black circle on the layer beneath it. If I were to fill normally, Sketchbook just takes what layer I'm on and it fills that in. If I were to choose sample all layers and I fill, it takes from every single layer. So it's using even the layer below as a guideline to know where to fill. So that's all I have for gradients. That's all the time we have today. I'll link the gradient documentation for Sketchbook in the description if you guys want to read up a little bit more on them. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching, and I will see everybody in the next video.